For Barbara Leroy, one silver lining of teaching at home through the pandemic was having the chance to play her ukulele to keep students engaged during distance learning. And last month, when she went back to part-time in-person teaching at Joseph Casillas Elementary in the Chula Vista Elementary School District, the ukulele came with her. Now it's helping her students readapt to the classroom.
If a child has had a tough morning, you know, maybe that music can just kind of get them out of their head and out of that situation.
Leroy said it's not just the students who benefit from the sing-alongs.
There's just been kind of a lot of anxiety with being kind of on the camera and then now on in person. And when I play music and I just kind of get out of my own head and out of my own anxious feelings, and just centers me, so helps me to calm down.
And while educators have worried about learning loss and students falling behind, experts say that emphasizing academic recovery might just create more anxiety for students. Alix Gallagher is the director of strategic partnerships for a think tank called Policy Analysis for California Education. She said emphasizing arts in the classroom can serve as an antidote to this anxiety as students return to campuses.
We have to understand when kids come back to school, having been away, they're bringing not only potentially more varied academic challenges, but they've also had a wide range of emotional experiences, and their socio-emotional wellness definitely needs to be addressed.
For both Gallagher and Leroy, it's about helping students rediscover a love of being at school.
Things like the arts, band, visual arts, dance, sports, those activities that are kind of more often off to the side are actually places where students can bring their whole selves and find meaning and develop the relationships and connectivity to school that help them get through school and ultimately thrive as well-rounded human beings.
Bonnie Hunt, a first grade teacher at Casillas Elementary, said the social aspect of the arts also helps students as they emerge from a year in isolation.
I had a few students that were very isolated, had a lot of anxiety coming back into the classroom, and being able to draw and do art, which is an kind of an independent thing, kind of brought them out of their shell.
But academics and the arts aren't completely separate. Hunt's students spent the last week learning about the bugs and insects that pollinate flowers or aerate the soil.
I'm drawing like butterflies and things and animals that are pollinators.
They used paint markers to decorate the school garden. Hunt says this helps students gain confidence while learning the material.
They take ownership of it, and it takes what they're learning from a book and it makes it real. And when they can transfer what they've seen in the book or learned in the book and create their own, then you can really say they've learned it.
Hunt is retiring this year, but she hopes the new normal does not include the same hyper-focus on standardized tests. She's rooting for beauty and self-expression to make a comeback.
Whether it's creating something that makes them feel good about themselves, or something they've created that they're proud of, or something that they've created that takes their sadness away, then that's the most important thing about the classroom, not whether or not they can bubble in. Bubbling in is an art.
Joe Hong, KPBS News.